Hi friends, in this video we will see how HashMap works internally. Why we have to understand how HashMap works internally? The primary reasons are for interview. Many of the interviews, this is one of the most commonly asked question. And the second thing is, if we understand this concept, we can easily understand other concepts like how Hashset works internally, how linked hashset works internally, how linked hashmap works internally, all hashing techniques, how they will work internally, you will understand easily. So in this video, we will see how hashmap works internally, how we will create hashmap object by using constructor hashmap m is equals to new hashmap of. So what this constructor will do? It will create an empty hash map and default initial capacity is 16 and default load factor is 0.75. So the default initial capacity is 16. So the 16 buckets will be created. When you run this statement, 16 buckets will be created. Here each bucket is associated with an index. And in the each bucket, there will be elements will be stored in the form of nodes. These nodes are we can call as entries. And this each node or each entry will have information about key, value, hash and next. So key is nothing but when we are inserting any key value pair, in that it will, that key is called as key. So it will stores that respected key and its value will stores the value of that one, and hash will stores the hash code of this key, and next will stores the next element. Here node may be a single element or list of elements. So in any buckets, there will be a single element will be there, list of elements will be there. So if any bucket has, like consider in this third bucket, if you have list two or more elements, then that time this next will point the next element, that is the next node it will point. So the array of buckets we can call as table array or node array or entry array we can call. And the next is load factor. What load factor will help here? So if you see here, we have 16 buckets. If the 75% of buckets are filled with some elements, then the buckets will be added, some additional buckets will be added, that will be defined by load factor. So threshold is nothing but load factor into the current capacity. So threshold, so 12 is here, threshold is 12. So if 12 buckets are filled with some elements, then the buckets will be doubled. So that initially it will be 16. Once it reaches threshold is 12, that is 12 buckets are filled, the bucket, another 16 buckets will be added, and that threshold will become 24, and the number of buckets will be 32. And if we 24 buckets, the threshold is 24 buckets is filled, again double buckets will be added. So by seeing this one, we understand once we create a HashMap object based on the initial capacity or based on the specified capacity, the buckets will be created, and each bucket will have a nodes, and each node will have key value, hash and next elements. Now we will see how put method will work. If we created a HashMap object, buckets will be created. If you try to add any element to the HashMap object by using put method, what will happen? First, it checks whether the key is null or not. If the key is null, it will be placed into the table of 0, 0th index it will place. Why? Hash code for null is 0. So if the key, if you inserted key is null, then that time this whatever the key value pair we have inserted, it will be added in the 0th bucket. If the inserted value, if the key is not null, then it will calculate the hash code for key. So whatever the key we have given, it will calculate the hash code for that by calling hash of key method. This hash method is internal method of HashMap. Once it calculates hash code, then it will calculate index for method. So by using this hash and length. So if you see here, whenever we are using put method to store any, to add any element, this hash map don't go, like it will not go and blindly put in any of the buckets. or it will not insert in the sequential order. In the 0th index 1, 2, it will not follow. It will not insert blindly in any of the index bucket. So it will follow the process. That process is nothing but what we are discussing now. So it will calculate the index. So this index for method will return the specified index. That specified index is nothing but in which bucket the elements needs to be added. After that, what it will do? It will checks whether is the key is already present in that respective linked list or not. Consider if this index for method is written a third index. That is here in this bucket, it will not go directly and it will not put. It will check whether the key is already there or not. So there is a chance of there, right? Keys will be already exist. So first it will check whether the key is there in the respected index position, that is in the respected bucket. If key is there, what it will do? It will replace the old value with whatever the value we have provided, new value. If the value is not there in the respected index position or in the bucket, it will add that value by calling add entry method. So add entry method will add the key value pair in the respected bucket. So if we are adding any element by using put method, first it will check null element or not. If it is null, it will add into the 0th index. If it is not null, there it will calculate hash code. After that, it will find the specific index position. And if in the specific index position, if element is there, then it will be replaced. If it is not there, it will be added. Now we will see how this put method is written in the hash map class. So if you see here, this is put method. If you go inside, what it is doing? First, what it is doing? It is checking table is empty table or not. As we have seen, buckets will be 16 buckets will be created, right? Or based on the initial capacity, buckets will be created, right? If the buckets is not created, that is table array is not created, that time it will be created. After that, it is checking key is null or not. If key is null, what it is doing? It is put from null key it is calling. So this method is nothing but what we are doing in the table array. In the table of 0th index, in the 0th index, it is checking whether this null key is already there or not. There is a chances are there, right? Null key also will be there already. If it is there, it is replacing old value with new value. If it is not there, it is adding new entry. After that, if the key is not null, it is calling hash method and it is getting hash code. After that, it is calling index for method by sending hash code and the length of the table. So this method will return index position. In the respected index position, that is in the table array, in that respected position, the list of elements will be there, right? If element is there, it will be iterated. It will be iterated over that list of elements and it will checking that the key is already there or not by using double equals to method and equals method. What it is doing, whether this key is already there or not, checking. If the key is there, what it is doing? It is replacing the old value with the new value and returning that old value. If the linked list, like whatever the bucket is empty, or if it is not having that whatever the key we are passing, it is not there, then it is calling add entry method and it is adding into that respected bucket. So this is how put method will work. Now let us debug this one and we'll see how the number of buckets are creating and how the elements are stored. So let us run this program. If you see the cursor comes here, now we will hit the step over method. If you see here, when we run hash map m is equals to new hash map, it is creating a empty array. As of now, there is no elements. As we seen in the put method, first it is checking whether the table is created or not. If it is the table is empty, then the buckets will be added when we are calling put method. So now let us run this put method. So if you see, we have run this put method. If you see here, the table array has created with the, that is number of buckets is 16 buckets it has created. So by default constructor, what it will do? It will create the 16 buckets. So we are sure of how these 16 buckets are created. And what this method FB we have inserted. So the element is inserted in the 6th index. As we know, first it is not null, FB is not null, so it hash code is calculated and in the specific index position it is calculated and there is no element. When this is the first fresh object, right, there is no element, so it is added in the 6th bucket. So now let us see how the data is there. So if you see here, as we have seen, each node or each entry will have four parts, four kind of data it will store. That is key is nothing but whatever the value we have, key we have added, that is the key here fp. Value is nothing but whatever the value we have given here 19. Hash is nothing but hash code of this fb, the key. If we are writing fb dot hash code method, that time this hash code will return 2086, it will return. So this hash will store hash code of that key. And the next is pointing to the null, because in this bucket only one element is there, the second element or there is no element, that is the reason it is pointing to the null. So we understand each entry or each node will have four elements, that is hash, value, key and the next. Now let us step over to this one, and if you see, we have inserted null element. As we know, first it will check if it key is null, it will be placed in the 0th index. So if you see here, it is placed in the 0th index. And now let us see the data also, how it is there. So if you see here, key is null and the value is whatever the value we have inserted. Hash is hash code for null object is 0. That is the reason hash code it is having 0. And the next is null, because there is no element is there. Now let us add AA object. AA is added in the 4th index. Now let us step over it. And BB added in the 4th index. BB also added in the 4th index. Why? Let us view in the object format and we'll see. So if you see here, in the 4th index, we have key is BB, value is 0. Here BB is pointing to the 0th value. And hash code for this BB is 2260. In the earlier case, in the 0th index, we are inserted, there is no element, second element is not there. That is the reason next is pointing to the null. But in our case, is next is pointing to the other, some other element. Now let us see in that, what is there in the next also. If you see here, the next is pointing to the next element. So here we have AA, and hash code for that AA is 2260. And the next, now third element is not there. That is the reason it is pointing to the null. So by seeing this example, we understand if any object has same hash code, then and if we are having the same table length is the same, then that time that objects will be placed in the same bucket. This process is called as hash collision. In interviews also they will ask, what is hash collision? Hash collision is nothing but if two or more objects has same hash code and they are placed in the same bucket, that time we can call that one as hash collision. And now let us execute, now let us run this A1. And if you see here, A is placed in the 5th index. So based on this debug, we understand by using default constructor, 16 buckets will be created and how put method will work internally. Now let us see how get method will work. Whenever created a hash map object, buckets will be created. So when you run this m.get method, app.get off, if you are passing any key, it will not go blindly and it will not check in the 0th index, 1 index. It will not go blindly and it will check in the all the buckets and it will not return. It will not do like that. It will follow some process. So that process is nothing but first it checks whether this key is null or not. If the key is null, it will get to know it will be placed in the 0th index. So by calling get for null key method, it will checks. Don't think like in the 0th index all only null keys will be stored. It is not like that. In the 0th index, some other elements also will be stored based on that index for method returns. Based on that, the elements also will be stored. So get for null key method, what it will do, it will checks in the 0th index any key is there with null. If it is there, it will return the respected value. If it is not there, it will return the null. If the key is not null, that time what it will do, it will calculate the hash code. After that, it will call index method and it will find the in which index position it needs to check for that respected key. So this index for method give, hey, go and check in this respected index byte in the respected index, like that it will show. If there any list of elements are there in the respected index, it will iterate the elements and it will checks for the key by using equals method. If the key is already there, that is if the key is present, what it will do, it will return the respected value. If it is not there, it will simply return null. So if you want to remove an object, By using remove method, we will pass key, right? In the same way, it will go and check the null is key is null. It will check for in the zeroth index. If it is not there, it will call hash code index for method, and it will check and it will find the respected in the respected bucket. And if it is there, it will remove. If it is not there, it will not do. It will simply return null. This is how get and remove methods also work. Now let us see how this get method also there. How get method code also written. So let us go to this get method. If you see here, it is checking if the key is null. It is a get for null key. What is this get key? Get for null key is nothing, but it will check in the zeroth index. If the key is there, it will return the value. If it is not there, it is returning null. After that, if it is not null, key is not null, then it is trying to call this get entry method. It is checking whether the size is zero. If the bucket is zero, then there is no element, right? So it is simply returns null. If the bucket has size, that is if some bucket has there, then what it will do, it will checking for the hash code. Sorry, it is checking whether key is null or not. If the key is null, it will return hash code is returning zero. If the key is not null, it is getting the some hash code. Here they have written both getting index and iterating that respected bucket. So by using index method, it will find the specific index and iterating that one. If the element is there, if the respected element is there, they are checking with the equals method. If there is there, this method, this get entry method is returning that object. And finally, we are checking whether this entry is null. If it is null, it is returning null. If it is not null, it is returning the value. So this is how get and other methods also work. If a remove method also, if you want to see, you can able to see here. If you see here, remove method, what this remove method is doing, it is checking size is zero, it is returning null. After that, it is calculating the hash code, and after that, it is finding the respected index position. After that, what it is doing, it is iterating that respected index position. Here it is, what it is doing, it is checking whether that key is there or not. If it is there, as we know, this is a linked list. If you are removing any of, if you are planning to remove an object that is in between the linked list, that time what will happen? The previous elements needs to point to the next element, right? That assignments are happening here. So this is how put, get and remove and all other methods will work internally in HashMap. This is all about this video. Thanks for watching.